Om Shuklam Varadharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Om. Dear friends, welcome to Valmiki Ramayana. We were seeing the second sarga of the Sundara Kanda. And we have seen how Hanuman landed. Hanuman landed on a tall peak called Lamba Shikhara, from where he was able to see the other peak, that is Trikuta Shikhara. Trikuta Shikhara was that mountain with three peaks. And that mountain, on that mountain with three peaks, this Lanka Nagari is situated. And that Lanka Nagari, it was so beautiful. It was looking like the God's own city, that is Amaravati. And it was so well protected. So Hanuman had a long distance view of all that. And also he went close. He went close and he also saw all the people, the guards moving around with the fierce bows. And there were so many guard posts. And he saw all the defense structure. And Dwaram Uttaram Asadhya, he approached that northern gate. So that usually if we have seen the old fort walls, there will be huge doors, very, very impregnable, very, very tough to break in. So such huge doors will be there, mostly iron, clad with iron, steel and whatnot. And also all types of piercing instruments will be there to that. So like that it will be there. So Dwaram Uttaramasadhya Chintayamasa Vanaraha, we were there. So Hanuman, when he just went close, he thought, by seeing this whole defense structure, Tasyascha Mahatim Guptim Sagaram Cha Nirichyacha Nirichyasaha. So he just, on one side he is seeing that mighty city, city fort rather, mighty fort, such an impregnable fort, and all the defense structure, Mahatim Gupti. Gupti means Gupta. Gupta means to protection. Gupu Rakshane. Gupu, the root Sanskrit root, Gupu means to Rakshane, to protect. So when we talk about somebody as a Gupta, Gupta is a man who is protecting the society. How? By generating economy. All these traders who are called Guptas, they are the people who generate economy, and economy is what preserves the society. So that is the reason why they are called Guptas. So here Gupti, Gupti means protection. So all the defense arrangements he saw. And Sagaram cha Nirishyasaha. On one side this is a huge fort, and on the other side there is a huge sea. And Ravanam cha Ripum Ghoram, and also he thought of Ravana, who himself is a very great warrior. Chintayamasa Vanaraha. Then he thought in himself, Agatya Piha Harayo Bhavishyanti Nirarthakaha. Even if all the Vanaras, they come here, what will they do? What can they do? You see, this huge impregnable fort is there. Nahi Yuddhena Lanka Shakya Jetum Surairapi. So Hanuman's first impression is, when he sees the fort and all that, the first impression is, oh, it's so difficult, it's so impossible to overcome it. It is so impossible to defeat these people. Nahi Yuddhena Lanka Shakya Jetum. In war, it is impossible to defeat these people. And Imam Tvavishamam Lankam Durgam Ravanapalitam. This particular Lanka, which is situated in such uneven place, Avishamam Lankam, in such place it is located. Even if Rama comes, what can he do? Kim Karishyati Raghavaha. Then Avakasho Na Samnastu. Then he is just thinking, as a soldier, usually soldiers, they think from their point of view. When they see a particular place, they, what are the strength, what is the strength of the enemy and what is my strength and all that, they estimate, they try to make an estimate of what is the enemy's strength. Hanuman is doing exactly the same. He says, then he is thinking about the four strategies, that how four strategies are Sama, Dana, Veda and Danda. Then Avakasho Na Samnastu. Samna, for Sama there is no avakasha, there is no scope. Sama means a sort of reconciliation, some friendly talk and then a friendly about a mutual win-win situation, describing the win-win situation, etc. So that sort of thing, it is totally ruled out in the case of Rakshasas. Then, na dānasya na bhedasya. And dāna, there is no question of yielding anything. There is no way of yielding anything to these people because they themselves are so rich. All the riches of the world, they are plundered by these people and they are kept there. We have seen that Ravana is a person who has plundered all the wealth from all the rich people, and then he is enjoying all that. There is nothing to be given to them. Then Bheda also is not possible. Bheda is possible in the case of some small level people, but in the case of highly arrogant, powerful people, very powerful people, and such people, It is, there is no bheda. Bheda is not possible. Then naiva yuddhasya drushyate. Even yuddha doesn't seem to be possible. Yuddha means war. Even war doesn't seem to be possible. So probably no upaya. All these four upayas are a failure here. He thinks that is his initial impression. Of course, he is going to revise his impression later. Then he says, Chaturnameva hi gatir naranam, vanaranam, tarasvinam. Then he is thinking about his own strength, his own miss, this vanara group. Who are the people who are capable of crossing over the ocean? There are only four people who can cross over the ocean. Valiputrasya, Neelasya. Valiputra is Angada. Neela is another person. Mama Ragnyascha Dhimataha. Mama Ragnyascha and Mama Ragnyascha Dhimataha. We can break it two ways also. I have the ability. Then Raja is Sugriva. Sugriva has the ability. Angada has the ability. Neela has the ability. Only four people. Only these four people can cross over. For these four names also, some scholars have given some symbolic interpretation. What is Hanuman? Hanuman is Vayuputra. Vayuputra means that Agni, Vayu, is something which is, Vayu is associated. Then Neela. Neela is supposed to be the son of Indra, the fire god. When we saw in the Balakanda, Lord Brahma told all these people, all the gods, you have to produce your people with your Amsha among Vanaras, Rakshas, etc. So then all those people, they produce themselves, they produce their Amshas, and all the strength of that particular god is there in this particular person. So like that we have seen. So Neela is a person who has that, who is representing Agni. And then Vayu, Valiputra Angada. Angada is another person, Amgada is again representing A. In Sanskrit literature, A represents Brahma. That means Brahma. Gada means Kirtanam. Angada means Kirtanam. That is a person who is on the bhakti path. I'll tell you the overall meaning. Amgada means actually Amgada, a person who is singing the praise of Vishnu. Then Sugriva. Sugriva is a person. Sugriva. Griva means throat. Sugriva means a person of a nice throat. Who is called a Sugriva? Only a person who is a Vedadhyayi. A person who has studied the Veda and who can recite the Veda. He is a Sugriva. So these four people, what do they represent according to one commentator? Angada is representing the bhakti path. And Neela, Agni. Agni is representing what is called karma. All our karma is associated with yajna. Most of the activities, karma means, in olden days, whatever karmas which are prescribed in the Vedas, they are all associated with some sort of fire ritual. So that means fire god is supposed to be a witness for all the good activities we do. Because without fire, nothing happened. In every house also there used to be this fire. Ahavani Agni, Dakshina Agni, etc. This fire was there. So fire is supposed to be a witness for all the good activities, for all the activities which a person was doing. So that is the reason why in one Upanishad it is said, Agne Naya Supathara Ye Asman. He prays to Agni, O Agni, you keep in mind, you remember what are all the good activities we have done and lead us to find good lokas. So he is praying that Agni. So Agni is said to be a witness. So Agni is that is the path of yajna and karma. Then Vayu represents the path of yoga. Yoga, that Atma Sanyama, self-control, that yoga, dhyanam, etc. Hanuman represents that. Then Sugriva represents that Vedadhyayanam. So these four paths, bhakti, then again karma means yajna karma, then yoga and Vedadhyayanam. So these are four steps, let us say, four steps to cross the ocean of samsara. So when he says that four people can cross this ocean, then this is the meaning given. This meaning also is okay. It is not, we need not dismiss it. This is some Vaishnava Acharya, as I said, one gentleman called Sribhashyam Appalacharyalu, a very eminent scholar in Ramayana. Not only Ramayana, very eminent Sanskrit scholar of recent times. He has given this explanation, which I found it is okay. We need not be Vaishnavites to appreciate it. In fact, I myself am not a Vaishnavite, but I do appreciate this because it is something which is giving a slightly newer way of looking at it. And also Valmiki could have intended also, because Valmiki, when he is dropping all these words, He is aware of the overtones. When there is a word used, that word has a normal meaning and also has an overtone. What are the overtones? These overtones, if we see, so these paths, for example, this bhakti, then again karma, yoga and vedadhyayanam, these four, they are all different paths, or they are different steps, we can say, different steps, one after the other, which will read, or rather which will help a person to cross over the ocean of samsara. So then chaturnami vahi gatir, then after this yavat janami vaidehim, then Hanuman thinks, okay, let me not think about all these strategies first. First of all, let me try to locate Sita, whether where she is, yavat janami vaidehim yadi jivati vanava, whether she is alive at all or not. Let me first find out. Then tatraiva chintaishyami drishtvatvam janakatmajam, after seeing her, then I will think about this particular issue. Then, so he again thinks, even the normal form of Hanuman is too big, because we have seen that Hanuman grew into some sort of mountainous size. Then again he contracted himself to his normal form. Even the normal form is too big. Even in that normal form, if he goes to Lanka, he will be easily detected. So, anena rupenamaya nasakya rakshasim rakshasam puri praveshtum rakshasai rakshasair gupta krurair balasamanvitaihi. In this form, I cannot enter, because when there is so much of guarding, there is so much of protection, then mahaujaso mahavirya balavantascha rakshasaha. And these rakshasas, they are also very mighty. They look very strong, they look very formidable enemies. And now probably vanchana means deception. Deception is the only strategy. Vanchaniya maya sarve janakim parimargita. Vanchaniya, they have to be cheated. So this cheating also is permitted. Actually, without cheating, how can he go in? So he has to naturally cheat them. Naturally, he has to use a different strategy. And here we may get a doubt. Is it dharma to cheat and enter into the enemy camp? So this sort of thing, if we see what is called dharma yuddha, according to dharma yuddha, okay, you have to challenge a person and then you have to then face the enemy and then you have to conquer. But Hanuman is not following that thing. Hanuman is using what is applicable in this particular context. He has come as a messenger. For his primary duty is not war. His primary duty, if it were to be war, he would have challenged. His primary duty is not war. His primary duty is to locate Sita. And if he has to locate Sita, then he has to stealthily go. That is what he decides. Vanchaniya maya sarve janakim parimargata. Then, lakshya lakshyena rupena ratrau lankapuri maya praptakalam praveshtum me krutyam sadhaitumad. Lakshya lakshyena. That is in a very tiny form, which can be lakshya, alakshya. It is seen and not seen. Lakshya means it is seen. Alakshya means not seen. If you look at it very carefully, it is seen. Otherwise, in a split second, it disappears. So that lakshya, alakshya, and rupana, very, very small size. I have to go. And in the night, ratrau lankapuri maya praveshtavya. That is in the night, I have to go in a very, very small form. Then he is seeing all these rakshasas and he is thinking, in what guise can I go, in what shape can I go? Kena upayena pasyeyam maithilim janakatmajam. By what strategy can I go and see this janakatmaja? And adrushto rakshasendrena, not seen by the rakshasas. If he is seen by rakshasas, it is like seen by Rakshasendra only, because these people, they will capture him and then report to Ravana. So how to go without the notice of Rakshasas? Then he thinks about the duties of a messenger. What is the duties of a messenger? What is my duty? As a messenger, my primary duty is to see what is my primary task. Well, that primary task should not be any danger to that. That primary task or target should be achieved. And thereafter, if I can do something more, I can do. So that is how he thinks. He says, na vinashyet katham karyam ramasya viditatmanah. I should not spoil the basic task of locating Sita. Then ekam ekastu pashyeyam. That is, he has to meet Sita one to one. Because in case he goes there, and if he is captured, Okay, even then, okay, take it for granted that he is able to defeat all the people. And in that condition, he will not be able to see Sita one to one unless he kills all the people. Unless he kills all of them, he cannot see her one to one. So that is the problem. Ekam ekastu pasyeyam rahite janakatmaja. Janaka, I have to see her one to one. And now, what about Duta? Bhutashyartha vinashyanti deshakala virodhitaha viklavam dutam asadhyam. Any action, any small mistake, desha kala virodhitaha, that is, any action which we take, it should be the right action at the right time. It should not be the wrong action at the wrong time. If you do some wrong action in a situation, then even a small mistake, suddenly the man may get caught, the man may be exposed, and then it will be the total failure. So, bhutashyartha, that is even those tasks which are about to fructify. Then now, Hanuman has done 80% of the job, or at least 50% of the job. That is, he has crossed over the ocean. That itself was so insurmountable. He just crossed over the ocean. More than 50%, we can say. Now, his task is to go and find out, is to locate. So, in such a stealthy manner, he has to go and then he has to find out. So now, bhutashyartha, that is tasks which are about to fructify. Bhutam is already over, almost over. So even such tasks, if there is some slight mistake on the part of the dhuta, that is viklavam dhutam asadhyaya, in case this dhuta is not an intelligent person, then tamas suryodayetha, like the task gets spoiled. Then arthan arthantare buddhir nishitapi nashobhate. Then he is thinking, this is, once you take a decision, there should not be any prevarication. There should not be any further discussing about pros and cons about it. We should not think about the pros and cons. And buddhir nishita api na shobhate. Once decided on a point, there should not be any dilly-dallying. We have to go ahead. Ghatayanti hi karyani duta panditamaninaha. Duta means a sort of envoy or a messenger. May not be ambassador. A messenger is probably appropriate to Hanuman here. Ambassador is a slightly different thing. Ambassador is a sort of official representative. Hanuman, though he is also an official representative, ambassador is a person who stays here. Whereas Duta is a person who comes here and then again goes back. So Duta Panditamaninaha, if the Duta thinks that he is too intelligent, over intelligent, Panditamaninaha, Valmiki uses certain beautiful words. Valmiki, we have seen that Valmiki coins certain new terms, Panditamani. Panditamani means one who thinks himself to be a Pandita. Panditamanya is another word. Panditamanya also we have come across, used by Valmiki only. Panditamanya is a person who thinks himself to be a Pandita, but he is not a Pandita. He thinks himself to be a Pandita. So, Panditamaninaha. So, that is the reason why the poets, any great poet is said to give a lot of diction to the common man. One poet says, a poet is the person who gives a diction to the common man. That is, T.S. Eliot or somebody has said, a great poet gives a diction to the man. So, in fact, our own literature, there is a term called Bhasha Sankrantarunam. Bhasha Sankrantarunam means Valmiki Bhasha Sankrantarunam. That is, Valmiki has given such rich diction to all the succeeding people. So, all succeeding poets like Kalidasa, they all went in the footsteps of Valmiki. They all used almost similar similes. The same almost similar similes are picked up and similar similes are created by later poets. So it's like that. So here he says, Hanuman says, once you take a decision, there should not be any dilly-dallying. Let me decide how to go now. And I have to decide in such a way that na vinashyet katham karyam, vaiklavyam na kacham katham bhavet. I should go about in such a way that the main task is not defeated. The main task of locating Sita is not defeated. Langhanam cha samudrasya katham nuna bhaved urtha. And if that cause is defeated, the entire task of crossing over this Lanka, etc. will be defeated. What all he has achieved, 50% or more he has achieved now. And if there is some small mistake now, then all this 50% also will become zero. So, langhanam samudrasya na katham bhavet vrutha. It should not become vrutha. It should not be a wasteful exercise. Then he again thinks, mai drushtetu rakshobhi ramasya viditatmanaha. Then if in case I am seen, by any chance I am seen by these people, all my task will be a failure. So I have to go in such a way. Vayurapyatra nagnyatascharediti matirmama. When he sees the whole situation, he sees that even Vayu cannot enter without being noticed by the people there. Vayuhu api yatra na ajnyatah charediti matirmam. Ajnyatah means unknown. Even Vayu cannot move unknown in this particular place. And ihaham yadi tishtami svena rupena samvrutah. Then if I stay here, even here in my own form, if I stay here, it is a danger. I have to become much, much smaller. Tadaham svena rupena rajanyam rasvatam gatah. Then I will now become very, very small and Lankam avipatishyami. I will just get into Lanka. Then he is thinking like that and he is just waiting for the sunset. Iti nishchitya Hanuman suryasya stamayam kapihi. He is just waiting for the sunset. Probably he saw all this in the evening. And in the entire evening, he is just planning as to how he has to go and what shape he has to take. All that, he is planning in himself. Then suryecha astamgate ratrau deham samkshipya marutihi. Then deham samkshipya, he became very, very small. Prushadamshaka matrotha. Prushadamshaka. Prushadamshaka means a small cat. Prusha means a rat or a mouse. Prushadamshaka means that which kills the mouse or mice is the cat, small cat. A small cat, he became of the size of a small cat. Bahuva Adbhuta Darshanaha. He looked wonderful. Adbhuta Darshanaha means he looked so wonderful in that particular size. Then, Pradoshakali Hanuman Sturna Mutpatya Viryavan Pravivesha Purim Ramyam Pravibhakta Mahapatham. Then, Pradoshakali. Pradoshakali means, that is, Pradosha is evening time, that is dusk, as we call it dusk. At that dusk, the time of dusk, Hanuman, he just went near from this Lamba Shikara, he was just moving around. And from that Lamba Shikara, he moves towards that Trikuta Shikara. And he goes there. Then he goes and he sees that Saptabhauma, Ashtabhauma Ishcha. He saw buildings which are Saptabhauma. So that is Saptabhauma means a seven-floored building. And Ashtabhauma, Ashtabhauma is eight-floored building. Then Sadadarsha Mahapurim. Then Salai Spatika Sankashai. There is a description of that city and what not. Then Achintyam Adbhutakaram Drushvalankam Mahakapihi. Then he saw Achintya. Achintya means something which is inestimable, unimaginable. You can't imagine the greatness or you can't imagine the defense structure, the way it is protected. Then Adbhutakara, such a wonderful structure. Then Asid Vishanno Hrushtasya Vaidehya Darshanotsukaha. There were mixed feelings in Hanuman. Vishannaha Hrushtasya. He became Vishanna. Vishanna means Vishadam. Vishada, we know that Arjuna Vishada Yoga. Arjuna Vishada Yoga means Arjuna, he just collapses in that chariot. Vishada means just collapsing down, falling down, collapsing. He just dropped his bow and arrow and he just sat at the base of the chariot. That is Vishada. Siddha, Siddha Dhatu. Siddha means to sit. Vishada means just to sit in a helpless way. Vishanna is a person who becomes helpless in that manner. So Hanuman also for a moment, he became Vishanna. Vishanna means, oh, how to go ahead in this task. He also became like that. And Hrushtascha, at the same time, he was also delighted to see. Hrushta means very delighted to see such a wonderful thing. Suppose you see such a wonderful thing, something which is very wonderful. So you really think, oh, it is so great. You feel happy to see such a beautiful thing. So he was happy on one hand. And he was also not exactly scared. He got rather dispirited for a moment. For a moment, we should say. So again, we see how he picks up courage and how he reassures himself. So he became like that. And then now that this sarga is coming to an end, now even the moon rise is being described in a different chandas. Chandropi sachi vyamevasya kurvan. Taraganair madhyagato virajan jyotsna vitanena vitatya lokan uttishthate neka sahasra rashmihi. That is, sandropi sachivyam eva asya kurvan. Sachivyam, sachiva. Sachiva means a minister. Sachivyam means functioning as a minister. Sachivyam eva kurvan, as though he wanted to serve as a minister to Hanuman. Chandra also. As though Chandra or the moon, as though the moon wanted to assist, as though the moon wanted to be the minister of Hanuman, that is Sachivyam eva kurvan. Then Taraganair madhyagato virajan. And Chandra is slowly coming up in the midst of all these Taragana. Tara, Tara means a star. Tara, star, related words. So in the middle of all, in the midst of all the stars, this moon is also coming up. Jyotsna vitanena vitatya lokan. Jyotsna vitanam. Vitanam is a huge canvas. And what is the canvas which moon is having? The huge canvas of moonlight. That huge canvas of moonshine he is spreading all over the earth. Vitatya lokan. All the entire loka, the entire world, he is spreading that huge canvas of moonshine. Uttishtate aneka sahasra. And moon is rising. And now he saw Hanuman also. He saw that dadarsya chandram cha sa kapipravirah poplu yamanam sarasiva hamsam dadarsya chandram. That kapipravira, that is Hanuman. He saw that chandra. Here again, that chandra also has some small significance. In our literature, chandra is supposed to be the adhidevata, the the divine spirit which controls the mind. Chandra is supposed to be the adhidevata, the presiding deity. Yeah, the presiding deity for the mind. And that is what we see also in Chandrama Manasojata Chakshosuryo Jayata. We say Chandrama Manasojata from that Virat Purusha. That Manas was manifested as Chandra. Maybe we saw our ancient people, they also saw, not only in India but in other literatures also we see that Luna, Lunar, Luna is moon, lunatic is something. During that full moon and new moon day, some people, they behave in very odd manner. That is called a lunatic, something associated with the moon. So that Luna, the Chandra or moon, is the presiding deity for the mind. Then it is seeing the moon is supposed to be very auspicious also. That is supposed to be the auspicious thing. And moon was looking like Popluyamanam Sarasiva Hamsam. So this moon was looking as though a hamsa. Hamsa means a swan which was floating in a saras. Saras means a lake, a huge lake. Lake, of course, is lake waters. Usually, what are the colors of the lake waters? Usually, they are slightly bluish in color. And in that colors which are blue, in that water which is bluish in color, there is a white swan moving. So in that akasha which is slightly blue, which is bluish in color, Chandra is moving like a swan, a wonderful simile. Popluyamanam sarasiva hamsam. So that saras, again, we can think of this manasa sarovara, this mind manasa sarovara. That is, Chandra, he is giving some bright ideas to Hanuman. Hanuman is getting, is feeling happy looking at that sun, at that moon, because without that moonlight also, it will be very difficult to search. So some little bit of moonlight is needed for him to search. So that is the reason why moon is supposed to be doing some sachivyam. He is functioning as an assistant to Hanuman. So that is how this sarga has closed. And we come to the next sarga. And next sarga, now he has to go. He has to really go. Now he is taking the shape of a small cat. And now he has to really go. And what he encounters there, we will see. We will see tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.